Okay, hi there. As the Champions League is underway and coming back tonight, I try at least to do some kind of prediction assisted by my Betmaster tool, which you can get your access to as well if you wish to, if you follow the link. And it is also doing quite a decent job, I consider. In the sense of doing some decent prices, in fact, for all the games. And if there are deviations, we may know why, and we may either agree or disagree, but we can, of course, discuss and argue a bit about it. And of course, it is a certain competition where decisions are to be made, and decisions, it means that some teams need a win or they don't care anymore, or some kind of these circumstances we have to look at. If we look at the Villarreal against Manchester United, of course the computer would still somehow support Villarreal in the sense of maybe they win a draw. And I wouldn't fully disagree, of course, because they are top of the table and they have, of course, their fate in their own hands. And they also, did quite well in Manchester and lost with the last kick of the game against Ronaldo. And of course Manchester United, even after the sacking from Ole Solskjaer, we do not know so sure where they are. And a draw would in fact be still fine for them, I would figure, because as I said, they will for sure have their fate in their own hands in case of a draw. Although Manchester United will take over. So we could consider this. Computer is a bit low with the goals. We did have some more, many of these games. And here it is really a tough task, even for my pretty well-worked out algorithms. I keep repeating that there is no real distinct goal average because they do not play every team against every other team in a round robin or so. The weaker teams are getting eliminated, and at some point, where does the Champions League start? And even in the group stage, we wouldn't know for sure because that's just four teams and six games. It's just too few to really evaluate. And next year we will have different groups and different teams in there. I'm still pretty proud that it works, but in looking at the goals, it doesn't always well convince me. Although it's quite decent, but we can always argue there. Here, that it considers to be a low-scoring game does not fully convince me. Because we saw the first leg as well. So the draw still, or 1x, that's what I would recommend somehow, because I'm sure I would like to support Villarreal. I know that Manchester United are considered to be the better team, but I would still wish to support in this game Villarreal by any means. I mean, 1x or just the draw. The Kiev Bayern, there's not a lot to talk about. It's everything decided here. I'm sure, even though in case Kiev still would have a chance for something to achieve, and Bayern wouldn't mind so much. But I'm happy with the 130. I wouldn't bet this. I wouldn't lay it. I don't want to be involved. Barcelona against Benfica is pretty interesting, of course. Barcelona can assure their place, and I was arguing in their favor before the last game, but they still didn't convince me with their efforts. Of course, everyone was expecting that or suspecting that. They still won the two games against Kiev, making this a final. But I'm pretty happy with the 169. It is going along with markets evaluations. In the Young Boys Atalanta, I would recommend Atalanta. I saw the first leg. Of course, it was a tight game, somehow 1-0. But Atalanta, they showed they know what they need to do. Young Boys are still building on the 2-1 win over Manchester United from the first game, but it was against 10 men and was a huge surprise. And later on, they may have shown that they are not the top side, really competitive at that level, but they are pretty okay. But if we get a 179 or 180, we see higher prices here. If we even get better, even better, or better still. That's Young Boys 3 points and Atalanta, of course. In case of a win, they have their fate in their own hands with 8 points and one of them being below or level on points, both of them in case of a draw. In the Via Wolfsburg, I wouldn't go for the Via. The computer says 164. We may get a little more, but they all the Spanish sides did not fully make such a good impression. Yeah, Villarreal were, for me, even the best of all of them, in some sense, I mean, compared to what you expected. But Barcelona, Sevilla, also Real Madrid, all of them a bit shaky, I would call that, right? While the English teams are cruising. In the Lille-Salzburg, I was expecting maybe the computer wants Lille. It doesn't even do so. I saw them in a couple of games. I think they are a bit maybe underrated. Salzburg, very good. But here we wouldn't even have a clear indication, a draw. I would not really consider. We saw Salzburg, they are so good offensively. And of course, they played a couple of unders here as well in the competition. But even the first one... still top of the group, although they lost to Wolfsburg. Of course, it's a crucial game here for all of them. Sevilla against Wolfsburg to come to 6 points at least, and also EuroLeague, and lots of things are within reach for them. And also the Champions League, of course, and Salzburg are nowhere near through or anything, right? So it feels like, of course, Lille know what to do, but Salzburg are very good, but maybe at that highest level, these young players, but they really know what to do, although they lost in Wolfsburg the last game, right? So it's really exciting there, and computer says somehow close to Sevilla you could go with, or maybe Lille, but I do not like both of them for some very good reason. Chelsea against Juventus, computer anyway is too low with the goals, and Chelsea are just cruising. And Juventus are really shaky, and I mean in the league, but with all their efforts, still topping the group, and they are through already. I figure, although they can only get 9 points, so they are through. We shouldn't care for this one. Of course, 165, maybe market somewhere, and sounds like an easy one for Chelsea, and those two are going through with this result. In the Malmö Zenit, we shouldn't bother too much. Maybe computer even suggesting to go with Zenit, making sure to win third place the EuroLeague. Why not? But Malmö made a fairly decent impression to me too. Of course, if we get a lot better than 181, then why not? I mean, you can make up your mind yourself. At least you see the figures here, and you have the huge comfort that you can also get these evaluations yourself on your desk if you secure your access to the tool. The 162 on Ajax are of course ridiculous. This group is more or less, I mean, Besiktas are out of competition, I would say. 0 points, I don't think there is any chance. Ajax are through. Why would we bother about such a game? I mean, computer would suggest 1x, and make up your mind yourself. Inter against Schachtel, computer goes a bit higher than market here. We have to check the group. And of course, Schachtel are more or less out of competition. They will all try. I'm very sure also with having still the Euro League in sight somehow with a win. But of course, that's pretty one-sided. You gotta expect, but Schachtel are not hopeless. I mean, I would say Computer is doing a good job here, and maybe a fair chance for Schachtel to even possibly win a point or something like that. But of course, for the what they are fighting for, it's Inter. They know what they need to do to stay in this competition. In the Manchester City PSG, I was arguing, I mean, we have these low expectancies, which is just wrong, I can say, although it would fit somehow to such kind of a game, but not in the moment in the Champions League, at the moment in Champions League. But it couldn't be bigger, the difference between when we argued in summer about which side are favorite to win the Champions League, and it was argued that Paris were the favorites. It was also market agreeing there after the Messi transfer, and they couldn't be further apart at the moment, right? And of course, I admit that this is ridiculous. This is going down to the few goals. But if we have the evaluation or keep this alive, and Paris are competitive enough maybe on the same level. That's what we originally thought. And also the first leg was won by Paris against Manchester City, right? 2-0 with a Messi goal. Of course, I understand that Manchester City are the much better side. If anything, we have to go with PSG that are struggling, and even the coach now in talks with the English Pochettino sides, and maybe not so secure there, and everything a bit messy. Also, they are still top in the league, and they are winning their games, but all the efforts are not fully convincing. Why Manchester City are dropping a point here or there, or losing even games. But they seem to be very stable, right? I'm sorry that I forgot to turn off my email program here. I wouldn't really, honestly, I have to go with PSG, but I can't certain that this is going to be a good bet. It feels like Man City are just winning the game. This is what it feels like. But I have to somehow stick to the evaluations, and I can't make them upside down after with a couple of games, but maybe it's about the time. In Club Brugge against Leipzig, Computer would once again give a chance to Club Brugge. We all know what it's about. They won the first game. They drew the first one against PSG, and they won the second one against Leipzig. But afterwards, they lost to... For Leipzig, it is the ultimate challenge here to take over and at least secure the EuroLeague. But I would admit that they lost on the weekend once again, 0-2 in Hoffenheim, and it is not consistent, their efforts. And Club Brugge still have in memory those very, very good efforts in the first two games. And they could come back to that. And I also had the impression in two of these losses, not against Man City, but in the other one, that they were at some point competitive and maybe even could have troubled PSG. I would go with Club Brugge, right? Atletico and Milan, there's only one chance to go with Milan. But the problem is, of course, here, I know that it was last year, it was the same story, I'm going the wrong way, that Milan somehow gave up even the EuroLeague for the league, for the competition. And this is pretty common, had been common in the Serie A, that they largely care for the title there, but they all understood in Italy as well that they have to try and make money, stay in the competitions, and they can't the Scudetto is very important still in Italy, but they can't give up here anything. And they didn't against Porto. They tried their best to beat Porto. They weren't able to. I bet on Porto in this case, not to lose. And but with a win, they would still keep some hopes alive. Although Liverpool could possibly lose even to Porto and still win the group. But anyway, it's also third place, that it's could be interesting. But a win, they can't just give it away. I mean, I would go for Milan here with the X2 because Atletico also didn't, like all the other Spanish side, did not convince me in this competition, right? And you see it here in the amount of points, or right, this is not a convincing performance. Also in the league, they may be somewhere close to the top, but all the efforts I saw, I witnessed, I wasn't quite happy with them. Liverpool, Porto, of course, we shouldn't talk too much about it. This is decided. The group is, of course, if some players will be rested and so on, and Porto have their chance, but Liverpool wouldn't just give the points away, I figure. And also, if some B players, the second garniture, or what it's called, would be fielded, they would still try to win the game, and they are very good. They sense their chance to maybe win a starting place for the next game, right? In the Sporting Dortmund, a tough one. I would figure Dortmund are going to win this game, but we know Haaland is missing. We also know that they didn't really perform so well in this competition here, and they lost twice to Ajax. It was a bad sending off, but still Ajax were just outstanding. But Sporting, they are no good. It's a strange group here with this Besiktas in there, which are not competitive while the others are. But I would figure they win without Haaland. And I was even intending to go with them until the computer showed me the 257. If I get a 260 or 255, maybe even 250, could be good enough. But maybe we won't get that price, because Sporting are not so good, I guess, right? That's why. But of course, it's daring here. Yeah, we know what it's about and what they need and so on. In the next one, we have Sheriff against Real. As I said, I mean, they still live on that win against Sheriff, which keeps them in the competition, right, when they beat Real Madrid, and they also beat Shakhtar, I guess, and they are not such a bad side, but I would say Real Madrid, no. Yeah, but a 120, 130, something, I mean, here the computer may be a bit low, as it is another Spanish side. And they also, I mean, Inter against Sheriff, I watched, that was a 3-1 win, but it felt like, I bet that one Inter, I think 130 or something like that, one maybe even 135, but it wasn't an easy game for them, right? So you can sense here they have a chance, but you won't get a huge price anyway. And so at what price would you start to bet Real Madrid? 130, would that be enough? Well, okay, that's the last one, in fact. So I'm gonna close here, and I hope you enjoyed it, and leave your likes, subscribe to my channel, and everything else you know about. Check out the tool. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.